things going in a way which had been expected before. There are no significant breakthroughs in the summit. However, it is going on in a quite a constructive way. So the very fact that the two leaders met is already a good sign, and this meeting may provide some sort of a spur for further dialogue on arms control and other issues on the working level and the level of their administrations.
In a sense, it's the outcomes rather than the summit event that matters, isn't it? I mean, I wonder what a successful summit outcome looks like for both sides.
Well, you see, it's hard to operationalize the concept of success for both sides. I think that the very fact that the summit happened is already a success, because the relations are on quite a low level. So the very fact of this dialogue, of this meeting, is a good sign. So I think both sides were interested in this, and the very fact that it happened is good.
I mean, the relationship really couldn't be much worse. We all know the long list of grievances. We've been detailing them earlier on in the program. I wonder who needs this more. Is it Putin or Biden?
Well, I think both of them need this summit. There has been no talk between the leaders since 2018. Meanwhile, these are the two great powers. And this was Mr. Biden who initiated the meeting, but it was fully supported by President Putin, despite, for instance, the sanctions imposed by the U.S. against Russia, despite all of the problems in diplomatic relations. So it was taken with no hesitation. So I think both were interested to the same degree.
The Trump-Biden era was often characterized as being very close, but in practical terms, I guess that it was strong on warm words. But when the follow-up came from the bureaucracy, there wasn't much content or even progress to report, was there?
Well, this is a very right notice. Very often when U.S.-Russia summits on the highest level occur, there are lots of over-expectations. And then it turns out that things are much worse on the level of bureaucracies. And I wouldn't have any expectations, over-expectations today, too. So there are lots of problems, and it's very hard to solve all the contradictions on the working level. So I agree that we will face all the same problems we have now.
Problems, there are many, as you suggest. There are, however, areas for both the United States and Russia to cooperate on, climate, COVID, and foreign affairs.
Well, yes, I would add a number of areas such as arms control, such as Afghanistan, such as Syria and Middle East, though there are contradictions there too, counterterrorism. There are plenty of areas we have their coinciding interests. However, at the same time, there are quite significant disagreements which affect in a toxic way the areas we have coinciding interests.
Ivan Timofeev, live from Moscow, thank you very much indeed for your analysis. And we do hope to take you